on the Lord's day. Amen. Who's ahead of our lives? And we give honor to the said man and woman in this house, the angels. Yes. Amen. Apostle. See you in heaven. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
I'm trying to make you excited. I feel hope in my belly. We thank God, amen, for our other family, my son and daughter, and the saints from God's Harvest Church. Amen. Apostle Clayton, the prophetess, mightily, let's thank God for them. God's Harvest Church, amen. And the saints of God, we honor the Lord. Amen. For his goodness and his mercy.
Yes.
Amen. I say, I honor the Lord. It had not been for the Lord who was on our side.
Yes.
Amen. It had not been for God. I don't know about you.
Come on.
And I know where I would be. How about you?
Yeah.
I said, it had not been for the Lord on your side. Where would you be? Hallelujah. Lord, bless his name. We want to say happy Father's Day to all of our fathers. Amen. We're here. Amen. It means much to be a father more than having a name.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
And a title.
Amen.
Amen. You got to have the goodness.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, I'm hearing about you right here.
Yes.
I said, you got to have the goodness.
Yes.
Amen. Because there's a lot of fathers, but they listen.
Come on.
Oh, I'm hearing about it. And there's some that are in there. There's some that are physically there, but they're not there.
Come on.
But thank God for the real fathers. Amen.
Amen.
But the glory be unto God. For the Father of all fathers.
Yes.
The Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Jehovah.
Yes.
And we give you praise today. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say, God is a good God.
God is a good God.
which is to love and fear God and be in Christ like.
Yes, God.
Yes, yes, yes.
Faith, love,
yes.
Steadfastness,
yes.
Patience,
yes.
And gentleness of heart.
Yes.
Talking about the name of God. Fight the good fight of faith.
Yes, yes.
Lay hold on the eternal life to which you were summoned. You were summoned to be saved. You were summoned to be who you are.
Yes.
You were summoned to have the ministry that you have. And for which you confess a good confession of faith before many witnesses. Matthew 11 and 12. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, until the present time, the kingdom of heaven has endured violent assault. And violent men seize it by force. A precious prize, a share in the heavenly kingdom, is sought with most ardent zeal and intense exertion. Let's go back to 1 Samuel. Let's look at verse number 12 again. And there were a man of Benjamin out of the army that came and came to Shiloh the same day. And his clothes went with earth upon his head. And he came low, and when he came low, Eli was set upon the seat by the wayside, watching, who was heart trembled for the ark of God. And the man came into the city. And so far the test. I'd like to use for a sermon this afternoon, will the real man of God please stand up and cry out?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Will the real man of God stand up and cry? Here in the text, the house of Levi, Eli, is devastated because the ark of God is no longer in the possession of Israel. This section provides a narrative that confirms the destruction of Eli's family's lineage. Just as Samuel's words to Eli in the previous section provided his verbal confirmation, as at other times in Israel's history, amen, they always had the presence of God until they sinned. We have people right now who are operating, amen, under the guise that they're still anointed, they're still chosen, they're still called, but they live in any and every kind of way. Mm-hmm. But we find out that when you do things that are void or to violate God's law, God will lift his presence.
Yes, yes.
I know you don't like to hear that because people in this day and hour, they want to feel like, I can do any and everything and still be anointed. I can talk to you any kind of way and still be anointed.
Yes.
Amen. I can treat you any kind of way and still be anointed. Amen. I don't have to respect leadership because I got a gift after all. Do you know who I am? Amen. I came to help your church. I know I said God sent me here, but I really came to help your church. I don't have to submit to you. That's the kind of people we're dealing with. And so we got people who are walking around, amen, in the body of Christ, singing who they are, but they don't even know that the presence of God has
left.
The ark of God represents God's presence. There is a religious spirit that has come into the house of God to reign God's
presence.
I'm going to go somewhere with this. Hang out with you, little brother. Amen. There's a rapist loose.
Yeah.
There's a serial rapist on
great.
The rapist title, the name of the rapist is called the Spirit of Deception. Yeah.
Yeah.
is a sister.
Yes.
I dare to say for going to
rest. Thank you, God. Thank you.
In the spirit of heaven's way. I may have been on the wall of babies who have been aborted. Now from the byway, I'm calling you out from the back.
Oh,
But you feel better coming to the altar, come on up here. Come, the altar is a place of transition. The altar is a place where things change.
Issues.
Do you really want to get rid of that? I want you to see yourself releasing it to God by faith. And say, I'm not going to keep living like this anymore. Jesus died for my food. He died for my deliverance. He died now in the peace that passes all understanding. And who the Son, the S-O-N, sets free, is free indeed. I will not be imprisoned in my own body anymore. I will not be imprisoned in my own emotions anymore. I will not be imprisoned in my own memory anymore. I let this mind that was lost on Christ Jesus possess me. Mind of Christ. Mind of Christ. Take me over. Take me over. Take me over. Father, I give it away. I give myself to you. I give myself to you. I will not hold any more grudges. intimate season with God is going to refine the church. Revival fires are being released. Hallelujah. Ancient, generational.
Yes, thank you.
For some of us, tribal.
Thank you.